Coins were also issued by tribal republics, such as that of the Yehudas, belong to which of the following regions? It's a very important question. The options given are A, Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka, B, Punjab and Haryana, C, Jharkhand and Odisha, and D, Manipur and Nagaland. The answer for the above question is Punjab and Haryana. B is the answer. So friends, these are important republics that were there in around the Punjab and Haryana region, and some of them were also there in, for example, the foothills of Himalaya. And many republics, they continued even during the Gupta time when they were subdued by Samudragupta and other people. So therefore, for the question, B becomes the answer, Punjab and Haryana. Coming to question number 2, which of the following statement are correct regarding the Gandhara school of art? The first statement that is given is the Gupta adopted the Gandhara school of art. The first statement is wrong, because it was the Gupta who adopted the Mathura school of art by, for example, by leaving all the foreign influences that were there. The school of art was the Mathura school of art, and the famous for its Yakshaginis, Apsaras, and for example the Naginis, and they were depicted in a beautiful manner. So first statement is wrong. Second statement, there were representation of a thick drapery with large and a bold fold lines. Yes, the drapery was large with a and bold fold signs. They were folded by one and another layers. B statement is right. The third, the most important Buddha and Bodhisattva were executed in the black stone by Gandhara school of art. Yes, the black was the black stone that was used by the Gandhara school of art. The statement 2 and 3 are correct. Therefore, for question number 2, B becomes the answer. Coming to question number 3, with reference to Ajanta caves, which of the following statement are correct? The first statement, Bodhisattva is also a striking feature of the Chaityas and the Viharas. The first statement is right. The Bodhisattvas has been represented. Mural paintings were present there. Yes, friends, there are 30 caves are there in the Ajanta, and out of them, 5 of the caves are having a mural painting in them. The third statement, it is famous for sculpture representing all religious sect. The third statement is wrong. Reason being, it is not the all religious sect. All religious sects, for example, the Ajivikas, the Buddhism, the Jainism, or for example, Brahmanism, all of them has been beautifully depicted in Ellora caves and not in the Ajanta caves. The Ajanta caves, in Ajanta, 30 caves are there, and all of them are there devoted to Buddhism only. So therefore, for question number 3, C becomes the answer, in which first and second statement are correct and third is wrong. Moving to question number 4, which of the following statement are correct, and we have to choose the correct code. The first statement, Viharas were used for the purpose of living. The first statement is right. It was the monks who used Viharas for the purpose of their living. Second, Chaityas were assemblies for the purpose of discussion. Yes, the Chaityas, various discussions were taking place, and it was the Chaityas which were used for discussion purposes. The third, Viharas were with the stupas. The third statement is wrong. It is not the Viharas, but the Chaityas were with the stupas. The Viharas did not have any stupas. Therefore, according to the question, C becomes the answer, in which the first and second statement are correct. Coming to question number 5, which of the following pair is incorrectly matched regarding the land under the Gupta period? The first statement, Kshetra. It is cultivated land, correct, cultivable land. Khila, Khila means wasteland. Vasti means jungle or wasteland. Third is wrong. The Vasti was basically a habitable land in which people were staying, and the jungle or a wasteland is referred to as Aprahata, A-P-R-A-H-A-T. Aprahata means the jungle or the wasteland. The fourth statement, Gupta Saraha, is a pastoral land. The fourth is right. Therefore, according to the question number 5, C becomes the answer, in which Vasti means a habitable land. Coming to question number 6, with reference to Gupta period of Indian history, consider the following statement which are correct. The first, Sartavaha was a caravan trader who carried his goods for different places for profitable purpose. Yes, the guild system that was important for the trade, the head of the guild, they were referred to as Sartavaha. It was he who was responsible for it. B statement, Narad and Brihaspati Samriti describe the organization and activities of the guild. Yes, both Narad Samriti and Brihaspati Samriti, it has been described that the guilds were organized and the trading activities were carried on by them. The Brihaspati Samriti refers to the guild rendering to the justice of the member. Yes, the guilds, they also had various power. For example, at various places, the guilds, they were allowed to maintain their army. The guilds, for example, they have the power to punish the erring member and therefore give justice. So therefore, for question number 6, all the 3 statements are right. Therefore, B becomes the answer. Coming to question number 7, match the following and we have to choose the correct code. Dharmantri is the author who wrote a book called Ayurveda. Brahmira, he wrote Brihasamhita. Harisen, he wrote Surya Siddhanta. And Amar Sima wrote Amar Kosh. Therefore, 4312, A becomes the answer for question number 7. Coming to question number 8. Bandipur National Park, also established as a tiger reserve under the Project Tiger, belong to which of the following state? Friends, Bandipur National Park, many time in news, is coming from our southern state, for example, Karnataka. It was established as a tiger reserve in 1974. Coming to question number 9. Which of the following is are among registered as the geographical indicators? First is Darjeeling tea. Yes, Tirupati Laddu also there. Kangra painting also there. Kashmir. Kashmir also there, all the four are correct. Friends, geographical indicator is a product that is primarily, it can be an agriculture product, it can be natural product or a manufactured product, for example, the handicrafts or industrial goods, originating from a definite proper geographical territory, and that has the characteristics of that, and those very product have, for example, the taste can be there, or the handicrafts, those goods can be manufactured over there, and they are specific to that particular areas of origin only, and therefore they are being given the geographical indicator title. Therefore, according to question number 9, D becomes the answer. All the four are correct. Coming to the last question of the day, which of the following pair is are correct regarding the tablets of the medieval India period? First, Alubruni, Tajikistan. It is wrong because Alubruni was there. He came from Uzbekistan, not from Tajikistan, and he came during the 11th century. Ibn Battuta, yes, it is Morocco. He came from Morocco and came during the 14th century. Francisco Bernier. Bernier came from France, it is correct, and he came during the 17th century. So therefore, according to the option, first is right, wrong, second and third are correct. So therefore, B becomes the answer for question number 10 for the day. So thank you very much, friends, for watching this video.